All right, Jamie, you ready?
For what?
I'm gonna paint you a word picture.
Okay, it's Sunday morning, the grass is high, it's time to mow the lawn, so you pull the lawnmower out of the garage, you start it up, and you start pushing around your lawn. That smell of cut grass coming up through your nose, it's great. So you're almost done, you're close to the driveway where there's some rocks on the lawn, and your lawnmower goes over one of those rocks, kicks it across the street, kills somebody.
Kills somebody?
Well, it doesn't actually have to kill somebody. The idea is that a rock kicked by a lawnmower can have an equivalent amount of force as a bullet delivered from a .357 pistol.
Lethal lawnmowers. I like it. If we're going to be testing whether a rock effectively becomes a bullet, yeah! When it gets hit by a lawnmower blade, we need to be someplace like this.
We've actually been filming in this very location for 10 years. Down there is the range in which Jamie and I first got trained to fire sniper rifles. Today, we are using one of their more remote ranges. All right, here we go.
Oh! Remote, because in an episode devoted to accidental ammo.
What are we doing with all this plywood? You'll find out.
The Mythbusters are bringing some ballistic bedlam to their soon-to-be-made backyard.
What did one sheet of plywood say to the other? Screwed.
Yes, we could do this test on a real lawn, but remember, this isn't about whether lawnmowers cut grass. We know this. This is about what happens to rocks when they interact with a lawnmower. I walked in my own path. So we've created our lawn laboratory here in order to remove variables and to clearly see what happens to those rocks.
Our experimental design today is pretty straightforward. We are going to lay down these rocks. Now it's starting to sink into me what we're about to do. Turn on this gas-powered motor and run it over them. What we want to witness is what happens in the reaction between the stones and the blade of the lawnmower.
This is gonna be a horror show.
Our blue figures are painted onto styrofoam, and so if any rocks come out of the mower with any force, this foam is soft enough that it should easily show it.
The mowers when Jamie was a kid didn't even have wheels. They had a really interesting name. They were called, what was it? Oh, goats.
Okay. Let's see if this thing starts up.
Modern metal mowers have debris deflection more than covered with this spring-loaded safety flap.
Nothing came out. We gotta pull that door.
But Adam and Jamie want to know what happens in the worst-case scenario.
It seems like the safety features work beautifully, but as you know on Mythbusters, that's never stopped us. The first order of business, remove this little door with the word danger on it. There we go. Safety feature removed.
With the mower now poorly maintained, the opening on the right-hand side means any debris propelled by the blades will hit the styrofoam targets. Adam, standing behind the mower, should be safe.
What's gonna happen?
Three!
Well, one thing's for certain.
Two!
Unless you're wearing hockey armor,
one!
You don't want to stand in front of the opening to that mower.
Anymore. This is terrifying.
I start the mower, and I get into a rhythm. It's the most terrifying rhythm I've ever been in. I actually ended up by turning my entire body away from this rain, this shower, this firestorm of little tiny pebbles. One even flew up in the air and landed on my hat. And I can't even picture the physics required for that to occur.
Good Lord!
I ran out of steam, and that is fine with me.
Here, I'm no expert with cameras, but that's bad. Am I right? That's bad?
I don't ever want to be behind a mower doing that again.
while Adam was behind the mower out of the line of fire.
I'm really sorry about that. I apologize here. I'll put that right there.
A veritable firestorm of stones and ricochets meant no one was safe.
Come here. Oh, my gosh. Hit.
With the foam onlookers peppered.
That went all the way through.
Wow.
The myth that a lawnmower can fling rocks at bullet-like force is clearly on the right track.
It threw this, that's heavy, with enough force to embed itself in this. I mean, I know that it's foam, but this is, I'm amazed.
So there's evidence the ballistic fallout is significant, but the Heinemann can't resist ramping it up.
This thing here is what you call a premium domestic lawnmower. It's a ride-on, and it's made to mow lawns fast. It's fun.
That's beautiful!
With an engine four times more powerful...
Jamie, are you ready?
I'm ready.
How much more havoc will Jamie wreak?
3, 2, 1, go! Oh, no.
I brought in the riding lawnmower and picked up where Adam left off. As you can see, there are no rocks left where I mowed. That mower moved them successfully off to the side with vigor.
Turn it up.
How'd I do? You know, I don't really care. You might want to think twice before inviting a Mythbuster to mow your lawn. I'm just saying.
Look, we have had fun so far, but it is important to remember that this entire story is about the interaction between a spinning lawnmower blade and a rock. How fast does it leave, and with how much energy? Now, were those rocks leaving the lawnmower at the speed of a bullet or with the same amount of energy? That we don't yet know. I think what we've got to do is take some of this equipment back into the shop, remove even more variables, and hone in to find out if they really are kicking those rocks with the energy of a .357.